Digital or online assignments can be designed in a lot of different ways that are really, creative, fun, and, interesting to students and to teachers while still being very pedagogically valuable. And so today I wanted to go over 5 ideas for final projects that you can do if you're teaching online or you just want to be, have a final project that is digital in nature. Okay, so we'll start with the simplest and go to more advanced, but here's a list of these 5 ideas. The first project idea is the simplest, and all it involves is 2 tools. So either PowerPoint or Google Slides, and then Loom. So Loom Pro is free to use for any teacher or student who signs up using their EDU email address. And I have a whole video tutorial on using Loom Pro, as well as a quicker video about different digital tools you can use, one being Loom Pro. And basically all it does, it records your screen and yourself while you're recording a presentation, in this case, a PowerPoint or Google Slides. And so the idea here is to have your final project be a presentation that students do and then record themselves doing on a video. And so using Loom, it automatically creates a hyperlink that students can just send you rather than having to worry about uploading to YouTube or to your LMS or any of those cases. It's just have them create a PowerPoint or Google Slide presentation about a topic of your course. And then after they create it, they have to present the information and record it for you. And so using the Loom Pro app, you just click record, they do the whole presentation, you'll see the screen as well as themselves, or just a screen if they don't want to be on the camera. And then once they finish recording it, they click done, and it automatically opens up on Loom Pro, they copy the link to you, send it, and that's the project, right? So it's just presenting either a final argument or a final, show that they are, strong in certain elements that they learned in the semester. Whatever you want to do as far as what they have to present is up to you. But the idea here is to create a really simple video that requires almost no tech knowledge. The second idea is also very simple. They only need, again, 2 tools. The first one being Canva to create infographics, and then whatever word processor they always use. And so this idea is to have your students create a set of infographics about, again, a topic in your course. And they can use canva.com, which is a free tool, to create these infographics. They have plenty of templates to help them get started. And then alongside the infographics, I'd have them create some kind of either maybe an annotated bibliography of their research that's included in the infographic, or maybe a narrative explaining their choices of design or the choices of what to put in there and what not to put in there, why they chose that topic in particular, who the target audience is, right? And so it can be a really simple project in the sense of the infographics, you have to, less is more, right? But they have to give some thought into what they're gonna put in it and how they're gonna design it. But I would have a reflective or research-based element to go alongside with it to kind of bulk up what they're doing in that assignment. And so again, canva.com to create a set of infographics about some kind of research topic in your course, and then alongside it, either a narrative or some type of annotated bibliography that proves that they did the research needed to create this infographic and thought about who it's for as far as their target audience goes. Next is creating a really simple free website where they curate their research and whatever else you want them to include in said website. So they can use something like Wix, or they can just use WordPress.com, which is for creating free websites, and I find it pretty user-friendly. And so again, this is really up to you to decide, but you can have them, for example, create an about page where they either talk about themselves, but I think it makes more sense to talk about what topic they chose to focus their website on. And then have them create, different pages in the menu, right? So maybe a page where they have, visuals tied to the research topic. And then a page where they have a list of resources that they found about this topic. A page where they have a blog post where they talk about what they've learned about this topic, et cetera, et cetera. So again, you could decide how, complex this has to be. But again, WordPress.com or Wix can be a really easy, user-friendly way for students to create this really great piece, right? Multimedia that shows that they've done the research. And I think it could be a lot more interesting to students than just writing, for example, a 5-page or 8-page research paper, and also more interesting to you to also read and view yourself. So you probably want to give them a guideline of what to include, as well as how you're going to be grading what they create in this website. Now these next two are more advanced, and probably a lot of students might not choose to do these two because they require more tech knowledge. And so I would suggest don't just assign one of these five, but have them like list the five, for example, maybe a few other options, and have them choose which one they want to do for their final project, right? And so the next idea is to have students create a podcast proposal along with an episode sample. So podcasts are very popular now. A lot of students and teachers, you know, listen to them. So you can have students propose a podcast about, again, a topic in your class. So you can have the proposal include what's the name of the podcast, what is the cover image going to look like, right? Who's the target audience of a podcast? What are you going to cover on it? You know, what types of topics will be included? Is there a certain theme you're going to do? Are your podcast episodes going to have a certain structure to them? Interview-based, non-interview-based, right? And so have them create some kind of maybe 2 to 3 page proposal for the podcast, and then also create one or two, right, maybe more, episodes for that podcast. And so that can be very simple. It can just be, you know, if they have an iPhone, they can just do the voice memo app, open it up, it comes with the phone, and just record themselves the audio file, and then obviously link that to the proposal. There's other avenues as well. They can actually create a podcast if they want to online, but or just have like video audio files, right, that they submit as part of the assignment. And so I think it'd be really interesting to see like how students figure out what topic they want to focus on, how they figure out who the target audience is. So again, like that, you know, second example, have them create some kind of proposal or reflective material alongside the actual podcast episodes. And I think it could be a really interesting idea as well, and a lot of fun for some students who are more tech savvy and who love to listen to podcasts. And then there's a video essay. So again, I have that video that's all about various online teaching tools you can use. And that one includes the use of QuickTime and iMovie along with Loom and Kahoot and Zoom. But in this case, have students create a video essay in which they argue something about a topic in your class, or they, you know, prove their advanced knowledge about a topic through a video, right? And so they can just, again, use their phone or their camera if they have one to record themselves speaking, or maybe record things, you know, in their house or in their neighborhood, right? If that's related to the topic, and then have them edit it into a video essay that they share with you. And so in this case, they probably have to upload a video to YouTube if it's too big for your LMS site to be just a file that they upload. But again, I think it'd be really interesting to students to show them, you know, how they can be, you know, more verbal and more visual in creating an argument, right? Rather than just having that formal paper that they write. And so it's up to you to decide the length, right, requirement for this, or the case may be, but I still think, you know, this could be something really interesting to students who like, you know, watching YouTube videos all the time, but why don't you try creating your own about topic for this course? So if any of these ideas really interest you, I do suggest hitting the like button below, letting me know that's something you value, as well as subscribing to this channel if you want more teaching tips, tools, ideas, and resources, or even just more generally about grad school life if you're a grad student. And comment below, what's your final project idea? Are you going to use one of these five, or do you have your own that you want to share in case we can use them as well?